Night two. Welcome to our second dance concert at Edison High. This is our third full year of dance, and with last year being cut short, the dancers' first question on September 1st was, will there be a live show? Well, here we are, and with an audience. Thank you for coming. I think it was a little more challenging than they imagined, but they did it, and I couldn't be prouder of their commitment and dedication. It took many after-school rehearsals, even a day of spring break, but they were determined. Not having the in-person time presented many obstacles, but I know you will appreciate and enjoy their creativity, their passion, and dedication to what they have accomplished. Please notice the acknowledgments and all the senior portfolios that are in the program. You can scan those QR codes and you can see all the work the seniors have done. There is a lot of work that was done behind the scenes, so on our socially distant intermission, take a look. We are on a skeleton crew, so bear with us. There may be some longer pauses than usual in between pieces. A few housekeeping notes, please turn off your cell phones. No recording, Mr. McDonald is here and he's amazing. You will be able to see everything and there will be a video pushed out in a couple of weeks. I won't hold you to anything, don't worry. So just enjoy the moment. Don't look through a phone screen. Also, we have to know that choreography is property, and it's theirs, so we need to respect and protect their creative products. No flash photography, it's dangerous to the dancers. And last but not least, thank you for being here and supporting these dancers. Enjoy the show.
I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady. Hold, hold on, hold up to me, 'cause I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady. I'm a little unsteady, a little
a senior at Edison High School. So my piece, it's called Querencia. The meaning behind it is about how we are stronger together and that being together isn't really about a place or where. It's more about who we're going to be together with. So over Zoom, we created the dance. We were able to finish it. But when we got to the studio, the dance really completely changed. We were able to finally finish it very clean and clear. We were able to go over it. And if anyone had any problems, or if they were doing the wrong leg, wrong arm, we were able to catch that and let them know. So everything changed. Even the timing changed because we were all together at the time in the studio. While on Zoom, it was more different because for some people it would lag and other complications like that. The dance program has given me many things, such as, number one, I have many friends in here. I was able to create so many friendships in the past. Even on my first year, I was able to create friendships that I still have nowadays. And not only that, I realized that this is kind of more of my second place to be. Other than being in the school, it was always my go-to, my favorite class, because we were able to all work together in dancing, which dancing is one of my favorite things to do. So it was more of a passion that I wanted to be here.
My mother said I'm too romantic. She said you're dancing in the movies. I almost started to believe her. Then I saw you and I knew. Maybe it's 'cause I got a little bit older. Maybe it's all that I've been through. I'd like to think it's how you lean on my shoulder, and now I see myself with you. I don't say a word, but still you took my breath and still the things I know. There you go, saving me from out of the cold. Fire on fire, we're normally careless with this much desire. Together we're winners. They say that we're out of control and some say we're sinners. But don't let them ruin our beautiful rhythms. 'Cause when you unfold me and tell me you love me, my eyes, you are perfection, my only direction. It's fire on fire. It's fire on fire. We're normally killers with this much desire. Together we're winners. They say that we're out of control and some say we're sinners, but don't let them ruin our beautiful rhythms. Fire on fire, we're normally kids with this much desire. Together we're winners. They say that we're out of control and some say we're sinners, but don't let them ruin our beautiful rhythms. 'Cause when you unfold me and tell me you love me and look in my eyes, you are perfect. My only direction is fire, fire. You are perfection. My only direction, it's fire on fire.
Hi, my name is Crystal Ramnarine. I'm a senior and I'm in Ms. Jenkins' Dance 4 Honors class. The title of my senior piece is I'll Call Home to Her. It's a duet with Catalina and JD. The main theme of this piece is loneliness and solitude, and I think that's been a very common struggle that we've all faced throughout the pandemic. The biggest struggle for me when doing this entire process was definitely having to teach the entire piece over a Zoom call at 8 o'clock in the morning from my bedroom. But these two girls are amazing, and even though we couldn't necessarily work on the weight shifting and the partner work that happens in a duet over Zoom, when we got in the studio, it just happened so naturally, and it was like great to see because I was so excited that these girls were going to be able to take the vision that I had and take it to the next level. I know these two have worked together before, but I wanted to push them and see what they could do with something that I choreographed, and I was just really excited to see how they would work together, given a new choreographer and someone who hasn't necessarily choreographed a duet before. Being a part of this program has definitely helped me reach new limits. Like, I've been dancing for like 13 years, but I've never had the opportunity to be on the other side and be a choreographer and be able to have that artistic expression and be able to do what I want to do. And the program has given me a lot of resources to be able to be confident enough to do this, and I'm proud of myself for being able to do it and taking on a challenge like this.
Working on empty, is that the kind of way to face the burning heat? I just think about my baby, I'm so full of love I could barely eat. There's nothing sweeter than my baby, I'd never want once from the cherry tree. 'Cause my baby's sweet as can be, she'd give me toothaches just from kissing me. When my time comes around, lay me gently in the cold dark earth. No grave can hold my body down, I'll crawl home to her. Boys, when my baby found me, I was 3 days on a drunken sin. I woke with the walls around me, nothing in her room but an empty crib. And I was burning up a fever, I didn't care much how long I lived. But I swear I thought I dreamed her, she never asked me once about the wrong I did. When my time comes around, lay me gently in the cold dark earth. No grave can hold my body down, body done. If the Lord don't forgive me, I'd still have my baby and my babe would have me. When I was kissing on my baby and she put her love down soft and sweet, in the lonely light I was free, heaven and hell were words to me. When my time comes around, lay me gently in the cold dark earth. No grave can hold my body down, I'll crawl home to her. When my time comes around, lay me gently in the cold dark earth. No grave can hold my body down, I'll crawl home to her.
Victoria. I'm 17 years old. I'm a senior at Edison High School. I've been dancing in the dance program for about 3 years now. The title of my piece is called Metanoia. It means the journey of one's mind, heart, and the way of life. A little bit about me. The dance program has been my outlet to find my own club. I really didn't like anything else in the school. This was a way for me to express myself, open up, and show my emotions, because I really don't talk about my emotions a lot. And even though it's my senior year, this piece really brought out a different side to create a lot more than I know I'm capable of. My inspiration was about a year ago at the Middlesex County College, I believe, and there were two duets on stage, and it really like made me think what I can do to address the minorities that we're going through right now in our world. So you're gonna see a lot of stories throughout the piece, and it really made me think a lot about what I want to come through as a dancer and how can I address these through body movement and not words. Yeah.
Just because it burns doesn't mean you're gonna die. You can't. a special presentation for you tonight. Thank you. So, the National Honor Society for Dance Arts is a program of the National Dance Education Organization, created to recognize outstanding artistic merit, leadership, and academic achievement in students studying dance in public and private schools K through 12. Their mission is to recognize outstanding artistic merit, leadership, and academic achievement, and to foster an appreciation for dance as a true art form worthy of recognition and prestige. Student induction into the NHSDA is awarded on the basis of points earned for meritorious work in dance and GPA, as well as cooperative teamwork, motivation, outreach, choreography, performance, teaching, and production. Inductees reserve a certificate of induction. So tonight, I'd like to induct our first ever National Honor Society for Dance Arts recipients. So let's start with Crystal Romery. Alicia Edwards. Carolina Casablanca. Alyssa Stoddard. Ashley Ayala. So you see, there are some seniors getting their honor cords because our seniors have also added an additional distinction and are being awarded graduation with honors. They have completed additional points as well as completing an essay. They will wear these NHSDA honor cords and gold honor pins during graduation, and they are also receiving their gold medallions. Step forward, Crystal and Alyssa. Congratulations. Thank you. As the program continues, our juniors, which is next year's seniors, will be eligible for scholarships in artistic, leadership, and academic achievements at both the state and national levels. Congratulations. We're going to enjoy a socially distant intermission. We will close the curtain, but the recipients are going to come forward for the families that would like to take pictures. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Francisco Velasquez, and I'm a senior here at Edison High School. And the title of my piece is called The Divine Psyonomachy. And what a psyonomachy is, it's an argument or a conflict with an imaginary or an abstract opponent. You know, what this piece resembles is my struggle with, you know, my mental health during the pandemic, especially during, you know, the middle of my junior year. And each dancer represents, you know, my depression, my anxiety, my yearning for, you know, closure from this, you know, struggle I was feeling. I feel like this piece really is an encore for me, almost like, you know, my last hurrah as a performer. And I just, you know, what this dance program did for me is provide this outlet for me. The costumes, you know, such beautiful costumes that come in such creepy masks. I do think that I aimed for kind of like some sort of irony in the costuming, you know, because you wouldn't imagine, you know, such, you know, beautiful dancers wearing very creepy masks. In terms of movement, it really all felt like, you know, I felt like I was throwing up the movement because it really did come, you know, suddenly. I never came to a single rehearsal prepared. I just moved the way I felt. Honestly, I never came to a single rehearsal prepared with what I wanted to choreograph. I always just did it. And it wasn't out of laziness, it was more out of, I can't choreograph when I'm, you know, when I just feel like it. I have to be in a certain mood to choreograph.
True, the past is not. day or two to exile from the light, to unfold that prisoner they call a mind.
Something always brings me back to you. It never takes too long. No matter what I say or do, I still feel you here till the moment I'm gone. You hold me without touch. To drown in your love and not feel your rain. Set me free, leave me be. I don't wanna fall another moment into your gravity. Here I am and I stand so tall. I'm just the way I'm supposed to be. You
Something always brings me back to you. It never takes too long.
my name's Alyssa. I'm a senior this year. I've been in the dance program for 4 years now. I was one of the first ever freshmen to be in this program and stick with it all 4 years. So this piece really means a lot to me because it was my first piece ever done in the dance program, but I changed it a little bit this year to connect it back to the dancers. When you're given a piece, it's usually what the choreographer wants you to portray of what they're feeling or something about the song, and I wanted this to portray everyone's feeling as an individual. I wanted them to have a moment where they can tell, you know, their story, what happened to them that changed them as a person. This was actually really difficult creating it because I took some of my original choreography and added some new things, but it was really hard because we were doing it online most of the time, and this was a dance where you need to connect with people at certain points and know that there was someone there for you after all these struggles. So it was really hard, but you know, we got through it, and I'm really proud of everyone, so I hope you enjoy it.
I want you to close your eyes. I want to ask you, how are you? What heaviness are you carrying? What tears do you hold back? What pain, what fears are kept inside?
It's just time. So is it wrong to dance this line? If your heart was full of love, could you give it up?
One day these fears are just going to completely disappear.
Cause what about angels? They will go make us special. Oh.
Can you forgive those who've hurt you?
Don't give me up.
Somewhere along the line, you changed. You stopped being you. You let people stick a finger in your face and tell you you're no good. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame. Like a big shadow. Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody. It's gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you wanna be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
Life is going to happen, and you're going to set up a plan, and you're going to have a vision, and you're going to hope that it's going to turn out perfect. But what so often happens in life is that things get burned and things go the wrong way, and it's in that moment that you're going to have to choose your reaction. You have a choice to make. Do you have the right reaction, or do you have the wrong reaction? Some of us were tempted, I'll just lay here and it will pass over me. I'm telling you, you will be in a vicious cycle forever. You have to get up.
If you get knocked down, there's nothing you can do about it. But getting back up has every single thing to do with you. And you will promise me that from this day forward, you will not be defeated.
Happiness.
Happiness,
where the one of time, but you know we just won't be. And if they try to stop us, see, we are called the NAACP. Cause the world keeps spinning around and around, and my heart keeps on time to the speed of sound. I was lost in the hurl of the wrong, then I found my way. Two kids under me, ever since we first saw the light. A man and woman like to shake it on a Saturday night. So I'm gonna shake and shimmy it with all of my mind.
I said it was a skeleton crew, so thank you to Fran.
2020. Gabby is our stage manager. Backstage, we have Brooke and Yen and McKenna, alumni that came back. It's also McKenna's birthday, and she's celebrating that with us. Thank you to Mr. Ross, who was here last night, and the custodial staff for making sure this happened. Dancers and their dance teacher are a lot, so we thank them for all they did and their patience. So we're going to recognize our seniors. Melanie, come forward. Our amazing senior choreographers, Brianna, Fran, Zaria. There are a few people in the audience. And Crystal. And Alyssa. And I got choked up last night, and I'll say it again to you guys, and I'm not just saying it. Amazing, amazing, each and every one of you for what you put into this program and what you have done. And I am so incredibly grateful and proud of you guys, all of you. Thank you. So a few people want to say some words, so I'm going to turn it over and see what happens.
Hello, I'm Alicia Edwards, Vice President of the BHS Dance Ensemble. I've been in the program for 3 years now. I first want to say thank you to Ms. Jenkins for working so hard to put the show together, always encouraging us and pushing us to do our best, and most of all, just believing in us. And then I want to say thank you to the seniors for being such great role models and always pushing us to do our best, always inspiring me, and I think I can say that for all of us. Thank you so much. Thank you to Crystal for being a great president and showing me the ropes of my country. Thank you for always making me laugh, telling me what to say in speeches, and most of all, humbling me at times. Even though this was an ideal year, I'm still so proud of how this piece turned out and how our show turned out. Next president, I inspire you all, and I cannot wait to see the dance program flourish.
She's never this nice to me unless she's in front of a microphone. Just wanted to put that out there. Anyways, hi everyone. My name is Crystal Ramnarine. I'm a senior. I've been in the program for the last 3 years, and I've been president for the past two. The first thing I want to say is thank you to everyone out in the audience for all your support, because without you, the show wouldn't have been possible. And to all of you lovely ladies and gents on stage, I just want to say how proud I am of all of you for all you've done, persevering through this crazy year to put on an amazing show. And I'm just really happy that I got to not only lead you guys this year, but learn alongside of you and love with you. I can't wait to see all that you guys do in the future, and I can't wait to come back and see how much you grow, not only as dancers, but as people too. I love you guys. And of course, I have to say thank you to Ms. Jenkins for everything you've done for me ever. I can't tell you how grateful I am for all of the lessons you've taught me, for all the times I can just go to your room and de-stress after school. I'm so grateful for everything you've ever done for me. I appreciate you so much, not only as a teacher, but I kind of see you as my mom too. I love you.
We stepped foot into this school together, and it is slowly coming time for me to walk out of it, but not alone, and not yet, we're not rushing it. You will always have an impact on who I am. Your teachings, lessons, and stories will help guide me through my life.
You, Ms. Jenkins, have become family. Family in my eyes is someone I can let into my life to help guide and support me. We get into arguments, have some times that we get sick of each other, but at the end of the day, I know no matter what, you will always have my back. You are someone I can come to with sad moments and happy ones, my biggest fears, secrets, and problems, because I know you will always listen and help me. I'm going to miss morning classes when I'm half asleep, morning talks in the studio, and being able to be myself around you and feel so comfortable and supported. You have gotten me through some hard times where I was at my lowest points. I know sometimes I can be a bit of a brat, crazy, and obnoxious, but I have to keep you young and on your toes. But anyway, enough of the sappy speech, Ms. J. Thank you, and I can honestly say, after 4 years, I love you. And don't forget, we'll be going to Guam soon.
Congratulations.